nearby are the great cities, but here the suburban landscape sets forth the dominant Japanese mood, tranquility. 20 generations of men have come and gone, but the Golden Pavilion remains. This 15th century villa of a court nobleman is as familiar to the Japanese as is this religion of the art of life, to promote enlightenment and mental composure. A ritual known to every family, practiced often enough right in the home. The tea ceremony, in its many variations, requires a small room, as simple and as pure as a Zen monastery, to inculcate humility. It is self-control, respect for procedure, discipline worthy of an orchestra conductor, timing and patience. Perhaps extending the thought, you can see how the same qualities have helped Japan climb to the rank of third industrial power in the world. Through the delicate aroma of powdered tea, hostess and guests take the time to savor life itself. By controlling the senses, one enjoys life all the more. To control the senses, to control the landscape too. In the Riwanji garden, firm stones are set in white sand that symbolizes the sea. The 15 stones represent a tiger in flight with its cubs from one island to another. The Japanese garden, in all its many themes and forms, is the attempt to harmonize nature's often wild beauty with man's need for peace. Nature to please man is the art of the garden. But to change the dimensions of nature, to dwarf its size while maintaining its proportions, is the art of bonsai. By cutting leaves and roots twice a year, you arrest the growth of trees. Take a spruce tree at 2 years, say. Then at 4 years. 15 years. 40 years. 100 years. It is about 2 feet high. The leading principle is heaven. The subordinate is earth. The reconciling is man. In the many modes of flower arranging, consider the nature of the flowers, usually three, where you will place them, the shape and color of the vase. To view the cherry blossoms at springtime is to be alive along with nature. The azaleas similarly are not to be missed. Hakone near Tokyo, with its mountain and hot springs, is a favored place indeed. Crowning Hakone, Mount Fuji, the mountain that spells Japan, her origins and her strength. Strength from the eternal mountain. Strength from the daily bath. You wash yourself thoroughly with soap before you enter the bath, never in the bath. The bath, then, is to gather strength and relaxation. Making things comfortable for the visitor is the tradition of Gifo, a mountain region between Tokyo and Kyoto. At That night, you joined one of dozens of boats for dinner and a show. Watching the hard-working cormorants dive for fish. A ring around the bird's neck makes it impossible for him to swallow the fruits of his labor. But he does get an occasional fish as a reward. This was once serious fishing. Now it's a tourist attraction. Tokyo by night jumps and jumps and jumps. The Ginza, that great technicolored way, reverberates with people out for a good time. It outdoes Broadway and Piccadilly Circus in sheer activity. Stretch it out and give it the dimension that people need. Courtesy, self-effacement, lubricate the machinery of life. The doors of the taxi open automatically. Thus does Japan make the new technology serve the old tradition of courtesy. Thus do past and present converge in the Japanese character, which is itself a huge part of the traveler's experience in this unique land. To say goodbye is to lose a friend, however temporarily. But prolong this moment of goodbye, and let your adventures in Japan become your memories.